So we were discussing about introduction to trigonometry. Last two periods we have discussed about all the six trigonometric ratios by using right angle triangle. The first one, first ratio, that is sine theta or sine a, anyway. Consider a right angle triangle here. A, B, C. At point B, there is a right angle here. Consider C as acute angle. The side which is opposite to right angle is called as hypotenuse, and the side which is opposite to acute angle, that is theta, is called as opposite side. And finally, the remaining BC is called as adjacent side, is also called as base. So by using right angle triangle, we are going to define the six trigonometric ratios. First one, sine theta. Sine theta is the ratio of opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So second ratio, that is cos theta or cosine theta, simply cos theta. Cos theta is the ratio of adjacent side or base divided by hypotenuse. So third one, tangent of theta or simply tan theta, it is the ratio of opposite divided by adjacent side. Then reciprocal ratios one by one. Fourth one, reciprocal of sine theta, that is cosec theta. Cosec theta is the ratio of hypotenuse divided by opposite. So next reciprocal, reciprocal of cos theta, that is secant theta or sec theta, is the reciprocal of adjacent divided by, sorry, hypotenuse divided by adjacent. Then finally, reciprocal of tan, that is cotangent, simply cot theta, is the ratio of, that is adjacent divided by opposite. So these are the six important trigonometric ratios. Now, as a reciprocal ratios, sine theta can be written as 1 by cosec theta, or cosecant theta is equal to 1 divided by sin theta, the product of sin theta and cosecant theta is equal to 1. Similarly, second one, cos theta can be written as 1 by secant theta, or secant theta can be written as 1 by cos theta, or product of secant theta and cos theta is equal to 1. Then third one, tan theta can be written as 1 by cot theta, or cot theta can be written as 1 by tan theta, or the product of tan theta and cot theta is equal to 1. So these are all reciprocal relations. Then finally, quotient relations, we have discussed already in previous class, quotient ratios. As first one, very important, sin theta divided by cos theta is equal to tan theta, and the second one, cos theta divided by sin theta is equal to cot theta. We have discussed all these in previous classes. Now we are going to solve question by using all these ratios given in the exercise 11.5. Now you consider first question. So exercise number, exercise 11.1. That's question number 1. In triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, right angle at B, that is B is equal to 90 degree. In triangle ABC, angle B is equal to 90 degree, AB is equal to 24 centimeter, BC is equal to 7 centimeters. Determine first one. Question number 1. Sin A, comma, and another one, cos A. So second question, sin C and cos C. Yes. If you want to write all the trigonometric ratios, sin A, cos A, next tan A, cosecant A, secant A, and tan A. Similar here, sin C, cos C, tan C, cosecant C, secant C, and tan C. So as your ratio. So if you want to write all six, otherwise just what they given, you should find one by one. Sin A, cos A, and sin C and processing. So these are the measures of right angle triangle. This is very important. Why? Because all six trigonometric ratios defined by using right angle triangle only solution. Draw figure right angle triangle. Yes, A, B, C. They given here. Angle B is equal to 90 degree. So this mark shows 90 degree. Next sine A. Correct? A means yes, first consider A is acute. So you have two different acute angles here. First time you have to consider A is acute angle. Second time C is acute angle. First you see here you consider A is acute angle. Hypotenuse first AB 24, BC 7. As I told earlier, the side which is opposite to right angle is called as hypotenuse. Here we consider angle A is acute. Therefore, BC is opposite, so this is very, very, very important. The remaining side, that is AB, is base or adjacent. For this triangle, I am right here. For this triangle, as AC is equal to hypotenuse. Next, BC is equal to opposite side. Then AB is equal to base. Base is also called adjacent side. We need all three sides. We don't know what is the value of hypotenuse. We know the value of AB and BC. We don't know AC. So we need all three sides. Why? Because you see the ratios here. Hypotenuse we need, opposite, even adjacent also. But here we don't have hypotenuse value. By using Pythagoras theorem, first to find the value of hypotenuse. Yes, what is the statement of Pythagoras theorem? In right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse, the square of the hypotenuse, that is AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. If not, you write in bracket B, PT. PT means Pythagoras theorem. In right angle triangle, the square on the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares on the remaining two sides. By using Pythagoras theorem, find the value of hypotenuse. AC square, we don't know, keep as it is. So what is the value of AB? They given here 24 square plus BC 7 square. So therefore AC square is equal to 24 square 576. 24 into 24. Don't multiply 24 into 2. That is wrong. 24 multiply 2 times, that is 576. Next 7 square. 7 into 7. That is 49. And therefore AC square is equal to 625, sum of these two, 625. Therefore, the value of AC is equal to, take square root to the RHS part, that is root of 625. What is the square root of 625? That is 25 centimeters. This, what is the value of hypotenuse? 25 centimeters or 25. Yes. Now write one by one. Okay, is it clear? First, you have to find all three sides of a triangle. Here, they give one. AB value 24, BC value 7. So, the question is sine A and cos A. We have to consider angle A is acute here. If A is acute, the side which is opposite to A, that is called as opposite side. So, therefore, BC is opposite. AB is base remaining side. The side which is opposite to right angle, that is AC, is called as hypotenuse. First, you find all three sides of a triangle. Here, they give one two sides. Find the value of hypotenuse. By using Pythagoras theorem, the square on the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares on the remaining two sides. So AC square is equal to 24 square plus 7 square. So AC square is equal to 24 square 576 plus 7 square 49. So AC square is equal to 625. Therefore AC is equal to root of 625. Therefore the value of AC is equal to 25 centimeters. Now you consider one by one. So here I will write all six trigonometric ratios, not only sin A, not only cos A. Sin A to totally cot A, I will write one by one. Yes. What is the value of hypotenuse? Just without the value. So hypotenuse is equal to 25. So opposite, that is 7. Base value, that is 24. Yes, now you write one by one. That's question number one, first one, I told you. Write all the six trigonometric ratios, sin A. So according to this, sin A means, as A is acute here, as what is the ratio? Opposite divided by hypotenuse. As sin A is acute, opposite means, that is 7 divided by 20 That's 5.5, that's 25. This is first one. That's next, cos A value. Cos A is the ratio of adjacent, is also called as base, divided by hypotenuse. What is the value of adjacent? That's adjacent, that is also called as base, 24 divided by 25. That's next, tan A. Tan A is the ratio of opposite by adjacent, 7 divided by adjacent, that is 24. Next, cosecant A. Cosecant A, I told you sine and cosecant are reciprocal to each other, just to make it reverse, that is hypotenuse divided by opposite. That's what about this one? Opposite divided by adjacent. Yes, hypotenuse divided by opposite, that is 25 by 7. Next, fifth one, secant A is the reciprocal of cos, that is hypotenuse divided by adjacent, so that is 25 by 24. Then finally, reciprocal of tan, that is cot, as adjacent divided by opposite, as adjacent divided by opposite, that is 24 divided by 7. The question is only two, just to make a practice, write all the six trigonometric ratio. Before that, finding the all three sides of a right angle triangle is very important. Without finding all three sides, we cannot write this ratio, because opposite, hypotenuse, adjacent, all three are sides of a right angle triangle. So now, consider second one, sin C and cos C. That's question number two. The simple change you have to make now. So instead of A, now consider C is acute. If C is acute, so automatically sign it will come changes. There is no change in value, but sides are changes. So C is acute here, so therefore AB is opposite. Why? Because the side which is opposite to acute angle, that is this is opposite of, so this is no problem. The side which is opposite to right angle is hypotenuse. Then the remaining side, that is BC, is adjacent, is also called base. Now we write one by one. So hypotenuse, that is AC is equal to 25. Next, opposite, that is AB is equal to 24. Then finally, adjacent is also called base, that is BC is equal to 7. Now according to these three sides, write one by one. So no need to write only two. Write all the six trigonometric ratios. That's first one, sine C. Sine C is opposite, divided by hypotenuse, according to this one, opposite, 24 by 25. Next, cos C is the ratio of base divided by hypotenuse. What is the area of base? 7 by 25. Next, tan C is the ratio of opposite divided by adjacent. What is the area of opposite? 24. Adjacent is also called base, that is 7. Next, cosecant C is the reciprocal of sine, that is hypotenuse divided by opposite, just to make it reverse, 25 divided by 24. Then secant C is the reciprocal of cos, that is hypotenuse divided by base, just again make it reverse, 25 divided by 7. Then finally, cot C, cot is the reciprocal of tan, that is adjacent divided by opposite, so that is 7 by 24. Yes. Here is the first question, first one and second. Okay? Yes. Now, let us consider question number 2, same exercise, second question. The given figure, right angle triangle, PQR, same exercise 11.1, question number 2. In the figure 11.13, not 8.13, find the value of tan P minus cot R. Yes, this is P, right angle at Q, so here R. The given measures, so this one 13 centimeter. So this one 12 centimeter, first you have to find or three sides, they give on two sides. So this is the hypotenuse, and these two sides so depend upon the acute angles. Before going to start, first to find the remaining side, that is QR, by using again Pythagoras theorem, square of the hypotenuse is equal to, that is PR square is equal to sum of the squares on the remaining two sides, that is PQ square plus QR square. In bracket to write PE, Pythagoras theorem. PR, what is the PR square, that is 13 square, is equal to PQ, 12 square. You don't know QR square, so keep as it is. Therefore, QR square is equal to 13 square minus 12 square. Therefore, QR square is equal to 13 square 169 minus 12 square 144. Therefore, QR square is equal to 25. Therefore, the value of QR is equal to root of 25. Therefore, finally, the value of QR is equal to 5 cm. Yes, what is the left QR? 5 cm. PQ, 12 cm. PR, that is hypotenuse, 13 cm. Now, the given question is, let's consider. Yes, the given question, we have to calculate tan P minus cot R. Tan P minus cot R. So here, we have to consider two acute angles. First case, angle P is acute. So angle P is acute. If angle P is acute, so this is called opposite side. Correct? We have to consider two acute angles here. First, while you are finding tan P value, consider P is acute. If P is acute, QR is opposite. So what about remaining? That is PQ is base. So tan P is, what is the left tan ratio? So tan ratio is given by opposite divided by adjacent. Correct? Here you consider the right angle triangle plus P, Q, R, Q, right angle. So P is acute. So this is opposite. This is adjacent. So this one hypotenuse. The value of hypotenuse 13, this is 12, this is 5. Yes, now you see tan ratio, opposite by adjacent according to this figure. Opposite, what is the value of opposite? 5. Just you got the value, QR, that is opposite. Next, adjacent value, 12. Yes, replace here, 5 divided by 12. Minus, cot R, as second case, you have to consider, R is acute here, P, Q, R, I told you earlier, there is no changes in the measure, so only changes in signs. Thus, this is 5. Consider second case, R is acute. If R is acute, PQ is called as opposite, QR is base, then, so there is no changes here, that is PR, hypotenuse. What is the ratio of cot? Cot and tan are reciprocal to each other, but here, R is acute, according to this, as ratio of cot, cot R is equal to as adjacent divided by opposite, adjacent, that is base, 5 by 12. So here we replace 5 by 12. This is equal to, so denominator same, 12, as numerator also same, 5 minus 5. So this is 0 by 12. So final answer is 0. Yes, any confusion? So here you have to consider two cases here. First case, P is acute. So P is acute means this is a figure. According to this figure, we will write the ratio of tan, that is opposite by adjacent. According to this, 5 by 12. Next case, consider R is acute. Let's consider this figure. If R is acute, so side automatically changes. So the side which is opposite to acute angle is called as opposite. So here there is no problem. The side which is opposite to right angle is hypotenuse. Then finally this is base. Cot means as adjacent divided by opposite, that is 5 by 12. So 5 by 10, 5 by 12 gets cancels. I take LCM, 5 minus 5, 0, 0 by 12. So 0 by anything is equal to 0. So this is second solution. Okay. Now we consider question number 3 now. Same exercise, question number 3. Yes, question number 3. If sine
to
3 by 4. Given that sin A is equal to 3 by 4, calculate cos A and find cos A. Calculate cos A and tan A. I told you better you find all the 6 trigonometric ratios, but the given question is only you have to calculate cos and tan A. Sin A is given. Remaining you write cosecant, secant and cot. There is no problem. Why? Because reciprocals of all these 3 trigonometric ratios. Yes, sin A given that. You can't first you draw right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. So consider A is at it here. So B right angle. Then C. So this is C. AC is called as hypotenuse. If A is acute, so this is opposite. Then remaining side, that is base. So sin A. So sin A is the ratio of opposite divided by hypotenuse. So therefore, the value of opposite is 3. BC value 3. Hypotenuse. Correct? So this is 4. Hypotenuse value is 4. Find the value of base again by using right angle triangle. Apply Pythagoras theorem. The square on the hypotenuse. AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. But here we need AB square. Therefore AB square is equal to AC square minus BC square. So AB square is equal to AC square. Just to replace 4 square minus the value of BC, that is 3 square. So therefore AB square is equal to 16 minus 9. Therefore the value of AB is equal to 7. AB square is equal to 7. Therefore the value of AB is equal to root 7. AB means that is the base value. Now to find one by one cos A. So cos A is the ratio of adjacent divided by hypotenuse. So adjacent value is also same as base. So root 7 divided by the hypotenuse value 4. Next, tan A. Tan A is the ratio of opposite divided by adjacent. What is the value of opposite? 3 divided by adjacent value root 7. To write the remaining 3. So cosecant A. So cosecant A is the reciprocal of sine, that is hypotenuse divided by opposite. So this is equal to, just to make it reverse, the given portion, that is 4 by 3. Next, secant A. Secant A is the reciprocal of cos, that is hypotenuse divided by adjacent. So this is equal to 4 by root 7. Then finally, cot A. Cot A is the reciprocal of tan, that is adjacent divided by opposite. So this is equal to root 7 by 3. So this is the solution for question number 3. Okay? So continue. Next question.